definition of calorific value of a solid or a liquid fuel, we are not taking into consideration of gaseous fuel, because by using this bomb's calorimeter, it is not possible to predict the gas, the calorific value of a gaseous fuel. We can able to detect only solid and a liquid fuel calorific value by using bomb calorimeter. The next thing under this chapter is a topic: determination of calorific value of a solid or liquid fuel using bomb calorimeter. Okay, so here the basic principle involved in the bomb calorimeter is the determination of quantity of heat absorbed by a solid or a liquid fuel. Okay, so by using by taking a known quantity of a solid or a liquid fuel which is burnt completely in excess of oxygen, this is allowed to burn completely in the excess of oxygen, and this burning should take place in a closed container called it as a bomb. Okay, a vessel, a cold a completely closed vessel is taken. In that, a known quantity of fuel is taken and that is made to burn. So during burning time, it emits heat, and that heat should absorbed by the surrounding water and calorimeter. Okay, the instruments looks like it consists of some stainless steel vessel, and that vessel is covered by means of water and the calorimeter, so that what the heat is released from this portion or from the fuel, that is absorbed by the water and the surrounding water and the calorimeter. That is, the quantity of heat absorbed by the calorie and the calorimeter and the water is exactly equal to heat liberated during the combustion of the fuel. Okay, by detecting the amount quantity of heat absorbed by the water and the calorimeter, we can able to find the quantity of heat released from the particular fuel. Thereby, we can able to detect the higher calorific value of the fuel sample. Okay, this is a basic principle involved in the determination of calorific value of a fuel sample. That is, heat released from the fuel, heat released by the fuel is equal to heat absorbed by water and heat absorbed by copper calorimeter. Okay, so this is equal. So our intention is to detect how much quantity of heat released by the fuel sample. That is exactly equal to the heat absorbed by water and the copper calorimeter. Okay, to detect this ones, we use an instrument called the bomb calorimeter. Okay, now I take the construction of this bomb calorimeter. You can observe the pictorial diagram of bomb calorimeter. See, this bomb calorimeter consists of a stainless steel airtight sealed cylindrical bomb in which the combustion of fuel is made to take place. So we will consider this portion. Okay, this is it is actually a closed by some lid. Okay, here this is a lid what we observe, and this is a stainless steel bomb. Okay, the entire thing what we observed here we considered as a stainless steel bomb. Okay, it consists of a stainless steel airtight, here there is no gap, airtight cylindrical bomb in which the combustion of fuel is made to take place. Then here the bomb has an inlet valve. You can observe here the bomb has an inlet valve in order to provide atmospheric oxygen. From this valve will provide atmospheric oxygen inside the bomb. And two stainless steel, here what we electrode is attached. So the two electrodes are taken, the two stainless steel electrodes are used, okay, in order to make a connection with the fuel. Okay, two stainless steel in order to make a combustion, it helps for the combustion of the fuel will take two stainless steel electrode used for the combustion of fuel. And again, so again, that two stainless steel electrode containing consists of, or it is attached to a magnesium ribbon, which help or it is connected to the fuel sample. Okay, to the one electrode. Okay, say to the one electrode, or directly a small ring is attached here. A small ring is attached, stainless steel or a crucible, in order to hold, support nickel or stainless steel or silica crucible. Okay, in which the fuel is taken. The bomb is then, it's a entire the bomb arrangement. Okay, here a known weight of fuel sample is taken on the stainless steel or nickel crucible. And then this entire thing, what we called it as a bomb, and the stainless steel bomb, that bomb is placed in a copper calorimeter, which is surrounded by an air jacket and water jacket. And this is a copper calorimeter. Okay, it will not allow the dissipation or the movement of heat. Okay, outside the copper calorimeter, bomb is placed in a well insulated copper calorimeter, okay, in which a known quantity of water is taken. This is what we call it as a what is taken is a water. Okay, a known quantity of water is taken, and it is surrounded by a water and air jacket. Here it is surrounded by air jacket, and further it is surrounded by a water jacket. Okay, then the uniform to make a uniform distribution of heat, it should be provided with an electrically operated stirrer. An electrically operated stirrer is immersed in order to make an uniform distribution of heat. How to read the rise in temperature during the combustion? So, because heat is released and that heat is absorbed by water and the copper calorimeter, and rise in temperature is detected using Backman's thermometer. And thermometer, what we called it as a Backman's thermometer, that gives an accurate rise in temperature. Okay, so this is the pictorial representation or the things of bomb calorimeter. Okay, it's a bomb calorimeter. Clear? So it consists of stainless steel airtight bomb in which the combustion of fuel is made to take place. It has one inlet valve in order to provide an atmospheric oxygen, because to come for the combustion, atmospheric oxygen is required. Then it has a two electrode, stainless steel electrode, in which a magnesium ribbon is attached in order to make for the combustion of fuel. To the one electrode, or directly a small small silica or stainless steel crucible is introduced in order to support, attached in order to, small ring is attached in order to support stainless steel or silica crucible, where the fuel is taken. The bomb is placed in a well insulated copper calorimeter, which is surrounded by an air jacket and water jacket, and that is mainly used to prevent the heat loss due to radiation. Then the calorimeter is provided with an electrically operated stirrer in order to make an uniform dissipation of heat, and a Backman's thermometer to read accurate rising temperature. Okay, this is about the construction of this calorimeter. See, it consists of stainless steel airtight sealed cylindrical bomb in which the combustion of fuel is made to take place. The bomb has an inlet valve for providing atmospheric oxygen. The two stainless steel electrode connected to the battery to initiate the combustion of fuel. To the one electrode, a small ring is attached, or here it is directly connected to the bomb. Okay, a small ring in order to support a stainless steel or a silica crucible where the fuel sample is placed. The bomb is placed in a well-insulated copper calorimeter, which is surrounded by an air jacket and water jacket to prevent the loss, heat loss. Then the calorimeter is equipped with an electrically operated stirrer for uniform dissipation of heat and thermometer to read accurately the rising temperature. Okay. Then what the working take place? Here, a known mass weighed pallets of given fuel sample. That means a known mass of fuel sample is placed in a small stainless steel or nickel crucible supported over the ring. A thin here magnesium ribbon, what we mentioned here, a thin magnesium wire touching to the fuel sample, as you've seen here, touching to the fuel sample is stretched across the electrode placed inside the bomb. Okay, it is just will make it a contact between the two electrode by short circuiting the it help to produce the fire or help for the ignition of the fuel. Okay, the bomb is sealed in an airtight by the lead. It is bomb is sealed by means of lead and filled with an atmospheric oxygen of about 25 atmosphere. Okay, atmospheric oxygen with a pressure of about 25 atmosphere is placed. Then bomb is then introduced to well insulated copper calorimeter containing known weight of water. So it should contains a known mass of water. Here water with the first weight of water is taken as W1 gram, okay, known weight of water. Okay, the water is kept constant agitation by means of a stirrer. Then initial temperature of the water is noted down, that is taken as a T1 degree Celsius. Then the combustion of fuel is initiated by passing electric current. When you pass an electric current through the ignition coil, the short circuiting take place, results the burning of the sample take place. Okay, then the combustion of fuel is initiated by passing electric current through the ignition coil. The sample burns in the bomb and heat is released, which is absorbed by the water and the copper calorimeter, which is absorbed by water and the copper calorimeter. The temperature of the temperature in the thermometer or the temperature of the water is gradually increases. Yeah, as the temperature releases, so or burning take place, it releases the temperature and it is absorbed by water. As a result, the rise in temperature is observed, increases and attains a maximum temperature. At one point, it attains a maximum temperature and that temperature is taken as T2 degree Celsius, maximum attained temperature. Okay. Then if you want, then you have to detect the quantity of heat absorbed by the copper calorimeter. That is what we called it as water equivalent of calorimeter, water equivalent of calorimeter. You have to detect calorimeter, you have to detect by taking a known, instead of taking a sample fuel, you have to take a known calorific value fuel sample, then burn. All other things are known and only unknown thing is the calorific or the quantity of heat absorbed by the calorimeter. Thereby, that can be detected and that is taken as W2 gram. That is expressed in terms of grams. Okay. Water equivalent of calorimeter is determined by burning fuel of known calorific value. Okay. So, if you observe the working of this calorimeter, you have to take a known mass of fuel sample. Say that known mass of fuel sample that is taken as M gram. Okay. Known mass of fuel sample is placed in a small stainless steel or a nickel crucible supported over the ring. A fine magnesium wire is touching to the fuel sample, is stretched across the electrode placed in the inside the bomb. Then bomb is sealed by means of a lead 25 and the oxygen is passed at 25 atmosphere pressure. The bomb is then introduced to a well-insulated copper calorimeter containing known quantity of water, that is taken as W1 gram. Then the water is kept constant agitation by means of a stirrer. The initial temperature of the water is noted, that is T1 degree Celsius. Then the combustion of the fuel is initiated by passing electric current through the ignition coil. The sample burns and in the bomb, and heat is released. The liberated, which is absorbed by the surrounding water and the copper calorimeter. Okay, the temperature of the water continuously increases, gradually increases, and attains maximum temperature, and that temperature is taken as T2 degree Celsius. Okay, then the heat absorbed by the calorimeter is detected by means of by burning a known calorific value of known calorific value of a fuel sample, or a known calorific value fuel sample of fuels of known calorific value. Okay, so that is what we called it as a water equivalent of copper calorimeter is detected by burning a fuel of known calorific value. This is about the working of this instrument. Okay, a known weight of fuel is placed in a small stainless steel crucible. The crucible containing the fuel is placed inside the bomb. A fine magnesium wire touching to the fuel sample is stretched across the electrode placed inside the bomb. The bomb is sealed airtight by lead and filled with oxygen at 25 atmosphere pressure. The bomb is then introduced to well-insulated copper calorimeter containing accurately measured quantity of water. Then the water is kept in constant agitation or stirring by means of a stirrer. The initial temperature of the water is noted. The combustion of fuel is initiated by passing electric current through the ignition coil. The time the sample burns in the bomb, heat is liberated, which is absorbed by the surrounding water and the calorimeter. The temperature of the water gradually increases and attains maximum value and is noted. The water equivalent of calorimeter is determined by burning fuel of known calorific value. Then what are the observations during this experiment? We know the weight of the fuel sample, that is taken as a M1 or M gram. Okay, then weight of water is known, that is called as a weight of water taken in the calorimeter, W1 gram. Then water equivalent of calorimeter, that is W2 gram, that is what we considered as a water, that is a heat absorbed by the calorimeter. That is, water equivalent of calorimeter is detected by burning a known calorific value fuels. Okay, initial temperature of the calorimeter is T1 degree Celsius, or the initial temperature of the water in the calorimeter is T1 degree Celsius. Maximum temperature or the final temperature of the water in the calorimeter T2. Then the calorific value of a fuel sample that you already know, according to the principle, heat liberated by a fuel sample is exactly equal to heat gained by the water and heat gained by the calorimeter. Yeah. So, heat liberated by m gram of fuel sample is equal to heat gained by water plus heat gained by calorimeter. Heat gained by water, you know, the W1 plus or W1 into T2 minus T1 multiplied by W2 into T2 plus W2 into T2 minus T1. So, in other words, we can take it this way, W1 plus W2 into T2 minus T1 calorie per gram. Okay, so therefore this is for m gram, therefore higher calorific value of fuel sample equal to W1 HCV equal to W1 plus W2, the same thing I am writing here, T2 minus T1 by m. Okay, this is in terms of calorie per gram. Okay, this is in terms of calorie per gram. So in order to convert it into SI unit, so W1 plus W2 into T2 minus T1, okay, into 4.187 divided by m, that becomes equal to kilojoule per kg, SI unit. So always while expressing the higher calorific value, you have to take into consideration of 4.187 multiply by 4.187, or you may write this equation this way. This T2 minus T1 is nothing but delta S will consider it as a delta T and multiply by delta S. This is this one for a conversion factor 4.187. Okay. So if you know the higher calorific value, you can able to find the net calorific value of the fuel sample. The net calorific value of the fuel sample equal to higher calorific value minus latent heat of water formed. So higher calorific value is Cv minus 0.09 H into 587 into 4.187 kilojoule per kg. So here 0.09 means it is a percentage of hydrogen present in the sample. 1 gram of hydrogen gives 9 gram of water. Therefore, 100% or 100 gram of hydrogen, percentage of water, that becomes 0.09 H into H is the percentage of hydrogen present in the sample, 5.2, 5.3, how much percent they given, we have to put it there. Then latent heat of water form 587, then conversion factor calorie to kilojoule 4.187. So thereby we can able to get net calorific value. So the net calorific value formula is higher calorific value minus 0.0591 into minus 0.09 H into 587 into 4.187. Higher calorific value is W1 plus W2 into T2 minus T1 divided by M into 4.187 kilojoule per kg. Okay. So this is about the determination of calorific value of fuel sample using bomb calorimeter. So I'll just recollect a known weight of solid or a liquid fuel is burnt completely in excess of oxygen and the liberated heat is absorbed by the surrounding water and the calorimeter. The heat liberated during the combustion of fuel is equal to the heat absorbed by water and the copper calorimeter. The higher calorific value of the fuel sample is detected by using the data. Then here the pictorial representation of bomb calorimeter. It consists of a stainless steel airtight cylindrical bomb in which the combustion of fuel is made to take place. The bomb has an inlet valve for providing atmospheric oxygen. The two stainless steel wire, or in other words, the stainless steel electrodes connected to battery to initiate combustion of the fuel. To the one electrode, a small ring is attached in order to support a stainless steel crucible where the fuel sample is placed. The bomb is placed in a well insulated copper calorimeter which is surrounded by an air jacket and water jacket to prevent heat loss. The calorimeter is equipped with an electrically operated stirrer for uniform dissipation of heat and thermometer to read accurately the rise in temperature. The working, a known weight of fuel sample is taken in a stainless steel crucible. The crucible containing the fuel is placed inside the bomb. The fine magnesium wire touching to the fuel sample is stretched across the electrode placed inside the bomb. The bomb is sealed airtight by lid and filled with the oxygen at 25 atmosphere pressure. The bomb is then introduced to well-insulated copper calorimeter containing accurately measured quantity water. The water is kept in constant stirring by means of a stirrer. The initial temperature of the water is noted. The combustion of fuel is initiated by passing electric current through the ignition coil. A sample burned in the bomb, heat is liberated, which is absorbed by the surrounding water and the calorimeter. The temperature of the water gradually increases and attains maximum, that is to be noted. The water equivalent of the calorimeter is determined by burning a fuel of known calorific value. Then, observation, weight of the fuel is m gram. A weight of the water taken in the calorimeter W1, water equivalent of calorimeter W2, initial temperature of the water in the calorimeter T1, maximum temperature attained by the water is T2, then heat liberated by m gram. We can represent W1 plus W2 into T2 minus T1 calorie per gram. Higher or a gross calorific value of the fuel sample equal to W1 plus W2 into T2 minus T1 by m into 4.187 kilojoule per kg. Lower calorific value equal to HCV minus latent heat of water formed, that is equal to HCV minus 0.0591 H into 587 into 4.187. So where H is the percentage of hydrogen present in the fuel